Hello?
This is Lauren Surratt.
Yes, sir.
Lauren, listen, my name is Roy Mercer.
Yes, sir.
Is you the horse trainer that sells mares and such? I bought a mare down in Pilot Point, Texas here a while back.
Yes.
And they said that you was the one that trained it.
The mare, her name is...
Mr. Kister.
Mr. Kister?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. I didn't train her. I bought her as a young mare.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. I've had her since, I think she was 3 years old.
Well, we got a problem.
Uh-huh.
Listen, last night, my stepdaughter, Latisha, had her welding class come out and see the horse out there.
Yes.
And they was patting on her and everything, and that dadgum mare bit one of the neighbor's kid's ears plumb off.
She bit the kid?
Well, yeah, it bit the kid's ear, took it right down to the nub.
Oh, no, there's something wrong. That mare was one of the kindest mares. There's something haywire because that mare is the kindest mare in the country.
Well, I don't know what got into her, but she done at that ear. And listen, that gal, little Lisa Loudermilk, she's a beauty queen contestant, and she's supposed to compete in a county-wide competition this weekend.
Uh-huh.
And then she ain't going to be able to do that without a daggum mare.
That mare is, and I swear, you can talk to anybody that is...
I'm talking to you, feller, and I tell you what's going to happen is that I'm going to come down there because she's all tore up, her folks is all tore up, and they's blaming me and a daggum horse.
No.
Yeah, that by God, they're threatening me. So what I need you to do, because the prizes in that county-wide beauty competition, she's going to get a couple $100 worth of jeans and clothes,
uh-huh,
$100 worth of cash, and a free pickup to drive around for a year.
Yeah.
And you're by God going to take care of that, or you're going to get your ass whooped.
What?
I said you're going to take care of that, or you're going to get you a country ass whooping.
Who are you, sir?
Roy Damn Mercer.
Where are you from?
I am from right around here. You're over in Tahlequah, right?
Yes.
Listen, I ain't too far from you. I'm down here in Old Mogi.
And what are you saying, sir?
I am saying that I need $300 in cash and some sort of a lease for a pickup truck for this gal to drive around for a year, or I am coming over there and we're squaring off.
Sir, just a minute. I'd like to record everything you're saying, sir.
How big a boy are you, Lauren?
Just about 6 feet.
Well, that ain't nothing for me to whoop a six-footer's ass.
No,
about ripe ass-whooping size.
Sir, just a minute, I need you to...
You ain't going
to
listen. I tell you what, all I need to know is how do I get out there to where you are, and if you're going to be there all day...
Oh, well, which I won't be, but that's immaterial, sir.
Immaterial? No, he didn't tear no material on her dress. He just had her ear off. And listen, we had to, the mare didn't swallow the ear. We put it in the ice chest and took it down, there in the emergency room. And we had a doctor down there. He thought he could sew it on. It stitched back on, but it looks like hell. It's a Chris Dever. Dr. Dever.
Oh, shit. You suckers.
Oh, Lauren, good Lord, you got a little upset there.
God, dang.
Hey, guess what?
What?
This is Phil and Brent and Roy D. Mercer,
uh-huh,
Tulsa, Oklahoma.
I see.
Somebody just made a horse's ass out of you.
I see.
Sounds like they don't hand out too many ass whoopings up there in Montana where you're from.
No, they don't.
Listen, it ain't nothing for me to knock you right up into the big sky country. I'll put you in the orbit.
You suckers.
Suckers, yeah. That's a curse word in Montana.
I believe it is. Yeah.